In this video, we're going to take a look at coloring a grayscale image using gradient maps. Now, whether or not an image is already colored, or like our example here, starting in grayscale, then using a gradient map would produce the same result. And it works by taking only the tonal values of an image, disregarding hue, and then allows us to map new colors at points along this tonal range. For this example, we have two layers, one containing just the face of our character, and the other contains everything else in the scene. Let's select the scene layer first, and we can find gradient map in adjustments, just here, and we can use it as either a layer filter or as a pencil filter. Let's go with layer. We don't have any area selected, so we'll be applying this to the entirety of our selected layer. Now, here in our gradient library is where all of our gradients are stored, including any of the ones we've created ourselves. To create a new gradient, we can tap the plus button just here, and this starts us off with a default black to white gradient. The bar along the bottom is our gradient, but it also represents from left to right the tonal range of the original image, dark to light. These color points along the gradient that we can drag around represent the new colors that we want to map to that area of this tonal range. We can tap on the gradient to create new color points, and we can tap on a point to change its color. We get all of our usual color selection options down here. Now, we always need at least two color points in order to have a gradient, but if we ever have more than two and we want to delete one, we can hold briefly on a point and then hit delete. So let's see all this in practice. We'll change the color of this point on the far left, which will map this new color to those darker tones. And we'll change the color point for the lighter tones on the far right. If we have anything else on the far ends that's not absolute black or white, then we're going to lose a little tonal detail. The same thing if we move the furthest points of the gradient inward. For example, if we move the left point in by about a quarter, then we're making the dark grays of the image, the new black point, capping off anything in the image that's darker than that. So let's go ahead and we'll lay down a few more color points here, and we'll try and keep a linear progression of tone as we work from dark to light. We don't have to, of course. There's quite a lot of middle grey in this image, so the middle area of the gradient would be prime real estate if we want to create some diversity in our hues. I kind of know what I'm doing here, but it is fun just to experiment and push colours around, see what feels good. This looks okay. Before we exit back to the library, we can tap on the namespace just here, and we'll give our new gradient a name. Something original, something fresh. And here is our new addition to the library. Now if we'd like to rearrange this space, we can drag and drop gradients to reorder them. Tapping on the canvas gives us options to preview our filter. Apply will apply the gradient but remain in the gradient map tool. Undo undoes any of the edits we've made so far, including moving and recoloring points. Or cancel, which leaves the tool without applying the gradient. We can apply a selected gradient and continue working by tapping on any of our tools, including the layers button. Let's do that. Now let's grab our second layer, the face. Let's go back to adjustments. Flicking down and left for layer filter. Now this time we're going to edit one of our existing gradients. We might want to keep this gradient as it is before we hack it up too much, so we're going to have to duplicate it. Holding briefly on a gradient in the library gives us the options to delete or duplicate. So we'll duplicate this and jump in and let's make some changes. For this we're going to shoot for a fairly base skin tone, nothing too complicated. There's not a tremendous amount of tonal variety in the face, but there's enough for us to get a bit of complexity, something that will work with the colors that we've already got. Another use case could be applying a gradient map, changing the layer blend mode and the opacity settings. Soft light blend mode, for example, is great for tweaking atmosphere of an image or color grading specific tones. I'm going to add some bluish dark tones. Just because it's darker around the border of the face, I'm trying to match that blue. It looks pretty good. Last thing we do before we apply this and leave, if we ever want to restore the default gradients, we can long hold on the plus button in the library until Restore Defaults appears. Tapping this loads in a fresh, duplicate set of the default gradients, so it will not affect or replace any of the gradients that already exist in the library.